हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। माय नेम इज़ मुस्तफ़ा एंड यू आर वाचिंग माय ट्यूटोरियल। दिस इज़ पार्ट 31 ऑफ दिस वीडियो सीरीज। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट रेंडरर 2। बिफोर आई मूव अहेड, आई वुड स्ट्रांगली रिकमेंड यू टू वॉच पार्ट 30 ऑफ दिस वीडियो सीरीज। दैट विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस वीडियो। रेंडरर 2 क्लास इज एन एब्स्ट्रैक्शन प्रोवाइडेड बाई एंगुलर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ सर्विस that enable us to manipulate DOM element without touching the element directly. This is best approach because of some security reasons like cross-site scripting attacks. In this demo, we will see how we can manipulate DOM without directly touching them. So let's flip to Visual Studio Code. This is the same example I worked in the previous demo, that is part 30. So if you run this example, you can see that we have a set HTML and the get HTML buttons. When I click on this button, I am able to set inner HTML in the div with red background color. When I click on the get HTML, I am able to get inner HTML. This is what we did in the previous demo. Now let's see how can we achieve same thing using renderer. This is the set HTML and the get HTML method that is written here in the app.component.ts. So here I am setting native element dot inner HTML property and I am assigning the value as mytutorial.com. In the same way, I am also setting styles and I am assigning background color to red. And here on the get HTML method, I am doing alert and getting the inner HTML. So we will see how we can achieve same thing using renderer. So working with the renderer, first of all, we need to import renderer. And as we saw in the definition that this is a service. You see this definition, this is a service. So for service, we need to inject that. I will explain you about service in my upcoming video, that how we can create our own service and inject them. So as of now, you understand that whenever we have service, we need to inject that in the constructor. And I will write private and I will give any name. So I will simply give renderer. So this is how we inject that. I will use private keyword and I will give any name, and then after the colon I will give name of the service. Now that we have injected, you know, a renderer, let's use it. If you see here, we are directly using this div element. Now we will achieve the same thing, but we will not directly touch it. We will use it indirectly. So let me comment this line of code. This dot renderer dot set property. And if you see here, the first parameter it is expecting is element. So as of now, I will use this div element here. So I will use this dot empty div dot native element. And if you see this empty div, I have already declared here in the app.component.html. So, and I am getting that using view child. And here, if you see the second parameter, it is asking for the name. So I will give this name as inner HTML. And if you see now the third parameter, it is asking for any value. So here I will give mytutorial.com. Save the changes and flip to browser. Now when I click on this one, you can see that we are able to set mytutorial.com in the div. When you click on get HTML, you can see that we are able to get HTML as well. And here is the code. Here using the renderer, I am able to set, you know, inner HTML. So you can see that we are able to achieve same thing, but we are not directly using this native element. We are using, you know, a renderer, and inside that we are using that. Now the question is, what is the benefit of using this renderer? Why we cannot directly use this? Now let's see what's official document of the Angular is saying about element ref. This element ref that we was using before, this element ref. So let's flip to slide. And here you can see that. Use this API as the last resort when direct access to the DOM is needed. Use this API means what? Element ref. Permitting direct access to DOM can make your application more vulnerable to cross-site scripting attacks. Carefully review any use of element ref in your code. Use templating and data binding provided by Angular instead. Alternatively, you can take a look at renderer, which provides API. API means what? This API. This is set API. We will see more API as we move ahead in this demo. So which provides API that can safely be used even when direct access to the DOM element is not supported. So you can see that how it is providing API that we can use to access HTML element in the component. Now what I want to achieve is, I will make a button here, and that button will add a color. So let's see how we can do that. So I have already written all the code, so I will simply uncomment and I will show you how it works. This is the, you know, add class and the remove class, you know, button. And on this button, I am calling add class and the remove class method that I have already added in the app.component.ts. So here I have add class and the remove class that will be called when I click on this add class and the remove class buttons. So see how I am doing it. I am using renderer.add class. And inside that, I am using the native element, this one. And then the second parameter, if you see, it is asking for the name of the class. And the first parameter is going to be element. If you see here, it is asking for the element. So I have already given element and the background color. In the same way for the remove class, renderer service and remove class method of that service, the same syntax here. Here I am passing the class that I want to remove. Save the changes and flip to browser. Let's set the, you know, HTML. When I click on the add class, you see that we are able to set background color. When I remove add class, we are able to remove class. Whatever we was doing here, the same thing we are also able to achieve using renderer. Let me copy this code here in the, you know, set HTML method itself. Save the changes. When I click on the save HTML button, you can see that we are able to set red background color. Let me delete this. Here also I will remove this and uncomment add style and the remove style. Now here you can see that in the add style, I am again using the same renderer service that I have injected here, and I am calling set style. This set style also accepts element and the style you want to apply. So I want to apply background color as red. If you see the second parameter, it is also of type, you know, a string, and the third parameter is of the type any. And here I want to apply background color red to this div element. So save the changes and flip to browser. And now you can see that, okay, so let me remove this style from here. So let me set HTML, click on the add style and click on the remove style. You can see that how we are able to set a style and remove a style. Let me remove this line of code as well. And this time I will set attribute. So let me uncomment this line of code and the HTML as well. Here I am using input control of the type text. So I will have text box. When I click on this button, I want to set attribute to this input control. Save the changes and flip to browser. Here that I am getting error, so we need to access that in the component. So for accessing that, I will use view child. And here I have given first name, you know, that is template reference variable that we talked, you know, a lot in the previous session. So I will use that template reference variable and I will give the same name. Now that the error should be resolved. So we are still getting the error. We should use the same name that I am using here. Save the changes and flip to browser. So here I have a text box, set attribute and the remove attribute. Let me comment these two, set HTML and the get HTML button as well. So I will simply comment it. Now you can see that I have two buttons, set attribute and the remove attribute, and I have respective method in the component as well. So in the set attribute, I am calling set attribute method of the renderer service, and I am passing, you know, value, and this value is hard coded. And when I click on this, you know, remove attribute, this value will be removed. So let's flip to browser. And when I click on this, you can see that inter value. When I click on the remove attribute, you can see that value is getting removed. This is how, you know, set attribute and the remove attribute works. I will recommend you to do a practical demo of the same so that you can better understand how this renderer works. You can see here that how I am calling set attribute method and I am passing all the, you know, required parameter. Now let me comment this line of code. The last example we are going to see is creating element. So we will see that how we can dynamically create element. So I have a button here and this button has create element method. So what is going to happen when I click on the button, this method will be called, and here I am creating li and a text and storing in the respective variable. Next, using the, you know, render service, I am calling the append child, and in this list, I am adding the text. And finally, this list item, I am adding in the div that is imported here, this div. So you can see that how I created list item and a text, and finally added, you know, text in the list item. Then this list item, I am appending in the div. So save the changes and flip to browser. When you click on this one, you can see that how we are able to dynamically add list item in the div. I hope you learned something from this video. If you really like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much.